Hello students, in the previous videos we have studied the cross product of two sets, and in this video I will explain the relations. And to understand better, I will start with an example. Later let us come to the definition of relations. Now here there is a list of students who scored 6 and more marks out of 10 marks, and instead of taking the students, let us take the roll number of the students. Let it be 19, 16, 10, 2, 13 and 5 are the roll numbers of the students, and we have the marks. And now we can map this marks and roll number like this. Let us take two sets A and B. Let A be the roll numbers and B be the marks. Here the roll numbers are 2, I'll write in ascending order, 5, 10, 13, 16 and 19. The marks 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This is the set B. Even the 10 marks is scored by 2 students, you have to take it only once. You know that while representing the set, elements should not be repeated. You have to write only once. That's why in the set B we have taken only once. Now if we map like this according to their roll numbers, now let us mark the roll numbers of the students with their marks. And roll number 19 scored 9 marks, roll number 16 scored 8 marks, roll number 10 scored 6 marks, roll number 2 scored 10 marks, roll number 13 scored 7 marks and roll number 5 scored 10 marks. This is the mapping from the set A to set B. And this itself a relation. Here, while writing this relation, as an ordered pair of elements, and we can write like this. It is generally denoted by R. Relation is denoted by capital letter R. Let us write like this. R is equal to the first element you observe, 2 comma 10, next one is 5 comma 10, next one is 10 comma 6, see there in the picture you can observe, 13 comma 7, 16 comma 8 and 19 comma 9, and this is a relation. Now instead of taking the marks obtained by the students, if we take the alphabet, that is first alphabet of the name versus the roll numbers, and it will be like this. Now let us take the set C as the first alphabet of the names and set D as the roll numbers, and it will be like this. The set C contains these elements S, N, that is the first alphabet of Nikhil, G, and A, that is the first alphabet of the Amok, H, and A is repeated here. Ashish is also having the A as the first alphabet, that's why we have to write it only once. And the roll number set is 19, 16, 10, 2, 13 and 5. And if you map like this, that is S to 19, N to 16, G to 10, A to 2, H to 13 and again A to 5. This is the mapping. And if you represent this in an ordered pair, it will be like this here. And R is equal to S to 19, that is S comma 19 comma N 216, N comma 16, comma G comma 10, comma A comma 2, comma H comma 13, and again A comma 5. And this is the relation. Let us take one more example. Let A be the digits, that is from 0 to 9. And again you take the set A, the same set let us take A, that is again a digits from 0 to 9. And if we map the element of A to A such that the element of the first set A is mapped to its square, and you will have this mapping. What is the 0 square? 0 square is 0. What is 1 square? 1 square is 1. What is 2 square? 2 square is 4. What is 3 square? 3 square is 9. Next, what is 4 square? 4 square is 16. And here there is no 16. There is, we have taken only single digit. That is the digits from 0 to 9. And now, if you take 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8, 9, for that there is no image. And this itself a relation. And here also you can write the relation as an ordered pair, and R is like this: 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 4, 3, 9. That's all. And this is a relation. Here you can observe that there is a mapping from the there is a mapping for the elements 0, 1, 2, and 3. And rest of the elements cannot be mapped to any element of A. And this is also an example of a relation. Now let us come to the definition of a relation. A relation R from a non-empty set A to a non-empty set B is a subset of the Cartesian product A cross B. Now, if you take the set A, which contains two elements, for example, you can take like this 1 comma 2, and if you take the set B, which contains three elements, and that is A comma B comma C, and there are three elements in the set B, and you know the method of writing A cross B. A cross B will have six elements, and the elements, I will not write the elements, 1a, 1b, 1c, 2a, 2b, 2c. There will be six elements like this. And if you write any one subset of A cross B, that will become a relation. I will write one relation like this here. R is equal to, and I will write one subset here, 1 comma b, 2 comma C and 2 comma A, and this is one subset of A cross B, and this is an example of a relation. And remember, every subset of A cross B is a relation, and here there are two elements in A and B is having three elements. How many elements A cross B will have? A cross B will have six elements. You know that. And now, how many subsets can be written for A cross B? 2 power 6 subset can be written, and each subset is a relation. This is the definition of a relation. Now, the subset is derived by describing a relationship between the first element and the second element of the order pairs. And here also, if you want to understand better, I will take an example. Now, if you take the set A, that is equal to contains two elements, 1 comma 2, and B is having three elements, and I will take it as 1 comma 2 comma 3. Now, A cross B will have six elements, and I will write a relation R such that the ordered pairs A comma B or X comma Y, such that X equal to Y. Here there will be two elements, and that is 1 comma 1 and 2 comma 2, and these are the two elements which satisfy the condition, that is X equal to Y. And this is the meaning of this sentence. Read the sentence again. The subset is derived by describing a relationship between the first element and second element. Here I described the relation such a way that x is equal to y. If I take x equal to 2y, then the relation is different. Now, the second element in the ordered pair under the relation is called image of the first element. Here, remember this word image. That is, the second element of the ordered pair is called image of the first element. Now, you try to understand these concepts. That is, the first one is domain. The definition of the domain is like this. The set of all first elements of the ordered pairs in a relation R from a set A to set B is called the domain of the relation. Here, if you take one relation, you have to collect all the first elements and that will be called the domain of the relation. Now, you take the example and you will understand better. And if we take A is equal to, and I will take one set A is equal to 1, 2, 3 and 4. A is having 4 elements and the B is having 3 elements. I will take one set B, 5, 6, 7. And A cross B will have 12 elements. And I will write one relation R is equal to, and simply I will take one relation 1 comma 5, 3 comma 6 and 4 comma 7. 4 comma 7. This is one relation. Because every subset of A cross B is a relation, this is a subset of A cross B and this is a relation. The set of all first elements of the ordered pairs in the relation R from a set A to a set B is called the domain of the relation. See here, what are the first elements here? And 1, 3 and 4. And these are the first elements. And this is the domain. Here, domain is, see here, domain of this relation is equal to, if it is repeated, you have to write it only once. 1, 3 and 4. And this is the domain of this relation. And read it again. Now, let us come to the other one, that is a range. Here the range is the set of all second elements in the relation R from a set A to a set B is called the range of the relation R. And I will take A is equal to, I will take the set A is equal to 1, 3, 5. And B is equal to, I will take the set B is equal to 2, 4, 6, 8. And I will write one relation R, which is a subset of A cross B. You can write any relation. I will just take on this. I will take one relation 1 comma 4, 3 comma 6 and 5 comma 6. And this is one relation because it is a subset of A cross B. And here the range is collection of all second elements. And which are the second elements here? 4, 6, again 6. And you have to write only once. If the element is repeated, you have to write only once. And this is the range of the function. I'll write a range, not R. Range. Range is equal to 4, 6. And this is about the range of the function. And the next one is codomain. See here, codomain is very simple. The whole set B is called the codomain of the relation R. And complete set B, whatever the set is given B here, and you have to write all the elements of B, and which is called as codomain of the relation R. And remember these results regarding the relation. The first is, a relation may be represented algebraically either by the roster method or by the set builder method. It may be given as I defined in the previous example, all the elements may be written, or it may be given in terms of set builder form. The formulae or the equation may be given. And second result is, an arrow diagram is a visual representation of a relation. In the beginning, I represented the relation by an arrow diagram, and which is a visual representation of a relation. We can represent the relation, that is either by roster method, writing all the elements, or by the set builder method, where the equation or condition may be given, or arrow diagram, that is just take the two sets and represent it a diagram. And note this result: the total number of relation that can be defined from the set A to set B is the number of possible subsets of A cross B, that means collection of all subsets. And you know that collection of all subsets is a power set, and each subset of A cross B is a relation. And here, if n of A is equal to P and n of B is equal to Q, there are P elements in A and Q elements in B, then what is the number of elements in A cross B? N of A cross B is equal to PQ. And therefore, total number of subsets, you know that, and each subset is a relation. Therefore, how many relations can be written from A to B? And total number of relations from A to B is 2 to the power PQ. You remember this result. If the numerical question is asked, you can apply this formula directly. And the last result is, a relation R from A to A is also stated as relation on A. And if it is from A to B, we call it as relation from A to B. And if it is a relation from A to A, just we say that a relation on A. And this is the theoretical concept of the relation. And in the next video, I will explain the method of solving the numerical questions. Thank you.